Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome back, friends. Welcome back to another video lecture by Kami Microbiologist. So this is the third video lecture of protein synthesis, and this is actually the series of video lecture which is going on. Okay, and in that series videos lecture, actually we talked about the protein synthesis, that how exactly a protein are synthesized. In the last two video lecture of the protein synthesis in prokaryotes or translation in prokaryotes, if you guys remember, we talked to the overview of the protein synthesis in the first video, and in the second video we talked about the genetic code, we talked about the arrangement of each genetic code, and we talked the transfer RNA, structure of the transfer RNA and activation of the transfer RNA, and we also talked about the ribosomes, their structure and everything, and we also talked the messenger RNA, their structure and everything. Okay, if you missed these video lecture, it is present into my channel, you can go back and watch it. Today in this video lecture, we are going to talk about initiation of translation in prokaryote in a detail. Okay, so let me start. Okay, so let me write. Now, what is initiation of translation in prokaryotes? In this video lecture, we are going to talk about the introduction of the initiation of translation in prokaryotes, and we are going to talk about the requirements, and we are also going to talk about the mechanism of initiation of translation in prokaryotes. First of all, let's talk with the introduction. Now, what is initiation of translation? Initiation of translation, again, it is a stage of translation in which the protein synthesis are started. How exactly it start? There are a specific codon which is present in the mRNA, which we call it start codon. From there, the protein synthesis will be started. But before that, there are some other sequences which we call that ladder sequences, or we also call that dalgarno sequences, which are found in the ribosomal RNA of the ribosomes of the 30S. So these sequences are also found here. So at that specific position, the ribosome will bind it here, and then it will move. And when it move and reach to the start codon, means AUG, after that the translation of initiation will be started. So this is in a sense about the initiation of translation. This is the introduction. Now what we need in initiation of translation, so let me write. Requirements. So in this case, we need messenger RNA, ribosomes, transfer RNA, and translational initiation factor like IF1, IF2 and IF3. Okay, so we need these main things in initiation of translation. Okay, so these are the main things that we need in initiation of translation. But what we need to understand about the initiation of translation, so there are some basic things that we need to understand before the translation, and these are the during the translation, and these are the, let me write, 30S and 70S initiation complex. So we are going to see that what is 30S and 70S initiation complex. All of you better know, complex means the involvement or the recruitment of proteins and some other messenger RNA and ribosome, all these things can make a complex. So we need these, so we need to know about that things. And moreover, we also talk the GTP and GDP. And moreover, we are also going to talk about GTPase. So GTPase is nothing but it is IF2. Okay, and this enzyme is just used to produce energy during translation. And GTP and GTP means GTP is converted into GDP. Due to this way, the energy will be released out. Moreover, we also talked about the ladder sequences, and we are also going to talk about the Shine-Dalgarno sequence. So these are the main things. Now these messenger RNA, ribosome transfer RNA, and translation initiation factor, these are the main things that we require in initiation of translation. And moreover, in initiation of translation, we need to talk about these things. Means 30S and 70S initiation complex, we need to talk about the GTP and GTPase, that how it converts the GTP into GDP. Moreover, we are also going to talk about the ladder sequences and Shine-Dalgarno sequences. Okay, so these are the main things that we need to know about that. Now what happened? These are the requirements. Now let's talk the mechanism. First of all, let me draw the messenger RNA here, and let me all label all the things that, let's suppose this is the messenger RNA, as you can see. So all of you better know messenger RNA have 5' to 3' end. Okay. Now, first of all, let me draw here the ladder sequences and start codon as well as the stop codon as well. So we are already talked about the genetic code. If you missed this video lecture, it is present to my channel. You can go back and watch it. Now these at that specific position, as you can see, there are some specific sequences are found, which we called it ladder sequences. And these sequences are UCCA. So these are the sequences which are found at the ladders, at that specific position. And remember, ladders, these sequences are called as ladder sequences. You know, ladder sequences is nothing but these are the specific sequences which we also called it ribosome binding site. These are called as ladder sequences or ribosome binding site, RBS. Okay. So these sequences are mainly found at upstream of the start codon. So we have also at that specific position, we have also the start codon, which are AUG. So at upstream of the start codon means almost 8 nucleotide. So before 8 nucleotide, there are some other 8 nucleotide are found at that specific position. So before 8 nucleotide of the start codon means at upstream, there are the ladder sequences are found, which we also called it ribosome binding site. So ribosome are mainly binded at that specific position. And that specific position, we also call that 5'UTR. What does UTR means? UTR means untranslated region. Now what happened in this case? All of you better know that these sequences are also found in the DNA. So in DNA, these sequences are transcribed. But in protein synthesis, these sequences are not translated. Okay? So it means that these areas are, that's why these areas are called as a UTR, untranslated region. At that specific position, just the ribosomes are banded here. And moreover, when the ribosomes are banded at that specific position, then at the ribosome, 30S subunit of the ribosome, there are the 16S RNA are also founded in the 30S subunit of the ribosome. And there are also some sequences which are found in the 30S subunit of the 16S RNA. And we call that Shine-Dalgarno sequences. So let's suppose if this is the 30S subunit of the RNA, as you can see. So inside this, as you can see, this is actually, there are some specific sequences. And these sequences are actually complementary to this one sequence. Okay, and the complementary of these sequences will be A, G, G, A, G, G. So these are the complementary sequences which are found in the 16S rRNA, means 16S ribosomal RNA of the 30S ribosome. Okay, so this ribosomes, mean this 30S ribosomes have a specific sequences which is found in the 16S RNA, which we call it Shine-Dalgarno sequences. Now, we don't call that Shine-Dalgarno sequences. Remember, when this sequences and this sequences both are complementary to each other, and when both are binded to each other, then at that specific position, we call that Shine-Dalgarno sequences. Okay? Now, at the 3' area, there are some specific sequences, means let's suppose at that area, which we called it UAA. So this nucleotide are called as stop codon. These are the stop codon. And all of you better know codon is nothing but it is the three nucleotide. So these three nucleotide are called as stop codon. There are also some other stop codon. We have UAG and UGA. Okay, but mainly we have any one of them. Sometimes we have also these three, depending upon microbes to microbes. Now, after this stop codon, there are some other specific region, as you can see. These regions are also called as ladder sequences. And this ladder sequences is called as 3' UTP. Now, why we call it 3' UTP? Because it is mainly found near to the 3' area. That's why we call it 3' untranslated region, sorry, not P, region. Okay, so these are the main things that we need to know about. So I hope you get idea about these things. Now let's talk about the protein synthesis or initiation of the protein, that what happened. Now in this case, this is the exact structure. Okay, let me draw the rough structure. Before that, you know what happened. This is the small sub, this is the small subunit of the ribosome, and this is the large subunit of the ribosome. And in the ribosomes, we have what? We have the three side, as you can see. Okay. Now, this one side is called as E side. This side is called P. And this side is called A side. E side means exit site. At E side, the uncharged transfer RNA will be shifted or will be migrated. Okay. At that specific area, there are those transfer RNA which carry the peptide chain. That's why we also call it peptidal site. A site are those site where a new charge transfer RNA are binded at that specific position. That's why we also call it aminoacyl site. Okay. Now this is the transfer, this is the ribosomes. So this is the 30S ribosome and this is the 50S ribosome, and collectively we call that 70S ribosomes. And it is, and in eukaryote, all of you better know, we have 80S ribosome. Now what happened? So again, this is the let's suppose messenger RNA. Okay. What happened? A messenger RNA, these are the ladder sequences. So here I am not drawing the sequences again. I am not writing the sequences at that specific position. As you can see, these sequences are found at that specific position. Now, first of all, the 30S subunit of the ribosomes are get activated and bound at that specific area. Why? Because the sequences which are found at that specific area are complementary to the 30S subunit of the ribosome. Because in 30S subunit of the ribosome, there are the 16S RNA. And in 16S RNA, there are the sequences which is complementary to this ladder sequences. This is actually called ladder sequences. Okay. So that's why the 30S subunit of the ribosomes, means the small subunit of the ribosome, will bound here. Okay. Now when it bound at that specific position, then after that what happened? This is the binding site. It will just bound at that specific position. Now this binding, ribosome binding site, is very, very important. Why? If this binding site or ladder sequences are not founded, then Shine-Dalgarno sequences will be not occur, or Shine-Dalgarno sequences will be not formed. Okay, so this area is very important. And moreover, for the translation, the ribosome should be bind and it should be a little bit move on. When the ribosome is a little bit move on, then after some sequences, means after the then during at the start codon, then the translation will occur, then the transfer RNA will bind at that specific position. Okay, but it doesn't mean translation will not occur, that it doesn't mean that ribosome will just directly bound to this start codon. Now it is wrong. A ribosome, that 30th subunit of the ribosome, will must bind at the ladder sequence. So at that specific position, the ribosome are just binded. Why? Because there are some sequences for the ribosome binding. So there the ribosome must bind. Now, just imagine, once the ribosomes are bound at that specific position, so then it will be easily moved. And this movement is very important for the initiation of translation. Now, when that 30th subunit are moved, so translation, initiation of translation will easily occur. So when it move, so then it will reach to the start codon. So let's suppose after that, you know, this ribosome will reach to the start codon. So this is again the small subunit of the ribosome, as you can see, and this is the start codon. Okay, now when they reach to the start codon, and in this ribosome, all of you better know, we have the three sides. So let me draw first, second, and third. Okay, now what happened? After that, you know, this 30th subunit of the ribosome will also carry the three initiation factor, IF1, IF2, and IF3. Now what happened? At each side of this 30th subunit ribosome, there are the IF3 binded at that specific position. So this is IF3 binded. And at A side, there will be IF1 binded. And moreover, at this A site, there is also IF2 binded. So IF2 are also binded here. And this IF2 is also called as GTP or GTPase. Okay. Now what happened after that? This P site is free, as you can see. So there will be no initiation factor are binded here. So it will be free. So all these things will be binded here, and this is actually a 30th subunit. Now after that, what happened? Transfer RNA get activated and it will be charged. So this is the transfer RNA. If you guys better know, we already talked the exact structure of the transfer RNA. So this is not the exact structure of the transfer RNA. So this is actually the transfer RNA. It will be, you know, charged. It means that the amino acid will be connected to this transfer RNA. So when the amino acid will connect it to this transfer RNA, then we call it charge transfer RNA or aminoacyl transfer RNA. Now it get activated. Activated means that amino acid are present with this transfer RNA. After that, it will be bind at this start codon. And the first transfer RNA, we call that formyl methionine or F-meth. It means methionine is actually the amino acid, and formyl is actually the methylated group. What happened? Why this methylated group is added? Why formyl group is added with this methionine? Because formyl group is added with the methionine, it will just important, because it will, once it bind to that specific area, then due to this formyl methionine, what happened? The IF1 and IF3 will be released out. That's why we can say that formyl methionine is very important. That's why this methionine should be formylated. So it will get activated and bound at that specific area. Now, these are the anticodon. Anticodon means there will be the complementary. This transfer RNA bound to that specific area. Why it bound to that specific area? Because they have the complementary sequences. And these complementary sequences are the UAC. So that's why it will bind at that specific area. So this is the first amino acid. It will bind to that specific area. Now, once the amino acid will bind to that specific area, then we call that 30S initiation complex. So 30S initiation complex will be formed. Okay. Now, when the transfer RNA are bounded here, let me draw the amino acid. Okay. Now, after that, so one thing that I forget here, what happened when the transfer RNA are binded here, having the amino acid, after that, this initiation factor will be released out, IF1. And After some time, the large subunit of the ribosomes are also bounded here. Now, this condition is called as 30S initiation complex. After that, the large subunit of the ribosome will be also bounded. And this is the 50S ribosome. They have also, you know, another main domain. Let's suppose this is the main domain. And we call that catalytic domain. Okay. Now, why we call that catalytic domain? Because this domain is very important and it is mainly found in the 50S subunit of the ribosome. Why it is important? Because it helps to form the peptide chain. Now, the peptide chain which is formed, it is possible by this catalytic domain. It has catalytic activity. Now, the amino acid which is connected with each other and the bond which is formed, which we call a peptide bond, it's possible by this catalytic domain. Okay, so it will be founded in the 50S subunit. So they have also these three sites. Let me draw. Okay, now when the 50S subunit are banded here, so then the IF3, moreover, the IF2 will also get released out. So all the initiation factors are released out. So what happened? E site is get free and A site is also free. Okay, now when the 50S subunit and 30S subunit, moreover, the transfer RNA, messenger RNA and the ribosome, this complex, as you can see, we call that 70S initiation complex. So let me write 70S initiation complex. After that, the 70S initiation complex will be formed. So this is in the sense about initiation of translation. Now when the A site is get freed, this is the A site and this is the E site. Then what happened? New transfer RNA will bind here. So we will talk it inshallah in elongation of the translation. So this is all about the initiation of translation in prokaryotes. I hope you guys get idea about the initiation of translation. But if still you have any kind of question in your mind, you can write it into a comment. I will give you answer as soon as possible. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, share this video, and definitely subscribe the channel and stay tuned, because in the next video, we are going to talk about elongation of translation in a detail. Thank you so much for watching.